simmering tensions at the Supreme Court, specifically among the court's conservative majority. And this is happening over the looming Roe versus Wade decision. I want to bring in CNN Supreme Court analyst Joan Biskupic from Washington. Joan, what have you learned?
Morning, John. You know, Clarence Thomas is the senior justice in the block that would completely overturn Roe v. Wade. And he recently took aim at Chief Justice John Roberts and said something that he never had said before. Clarence Thomas prided himself at never speaking critically about anyone on the court. And he said, specifically referring to the period just before John Roberts joined, that was when we actually trusted each other. We may have been a dysfunctional family, but we were a family, and we loved it. We had trust. Now, John Roberts is the one justice who right now is trying to forestall the absolute overturn of Roe v. Wade at this moment. He favors upholding the Mississippi abortion law before the justices, which would prevent a woman from ending a pregnancy after 15 weeks, of pregnancy, but he did not want to completely roll it back. And his greatest chance of making progress against what Clarence Thomas and the far-right conservatives want is to pick off Brett Kavanaugh or Amy Coney Barrett. And Clarence Thomas's words certainly laid bare what might be happening behind the scenes in terms of progress Roberts is making. And one other thing, John, I'm going to take you back to 2 years ago when John Roberts cast the swing, the single most important vote to strike down a restrictive Louisiana law. He joined with the liberals there, something he hadn't done before. But again, he really wanted to preserve something of precedent. And Clarence Thomas, writing for himself, said, Roe was made up of whole cloth. It has no basis in the Constitution. It is time to overturn it. It was egregiously wrong. And right now, John, I can tell you that Roe v. Wade will soon be overturned. The question is, will it be done immediately over protests from Chief Justice John Roberts, or will it, that sort of action be slowed because of some compromise that Roberts is able to do, again, over the criticism of those on the far right, and specifically these days, Justice Clarence Thomas, who's the leading senior in that block of justices.
So, Joan, is this a one-way street in terms of the enmity, in terms of where this is being directed? Is Roberts responding at all? And also, it's coded language, but what exactly is Thomas accusing Roberts of, not being on the up and up?
You know, it's funny you say it exactly that way, because Chief Justice John Roberts can be quite cagey about how he operates behind the scenes. I'm sure he wouldn't use that word on himself, and he would probably think, you know, he's just trying to deal with his colleagues as an honest broker. But he can be quite secretive. And the times that he has pulled out a majority, you know, essentially a rabbit out of a hat at a time when it looked like things were not going to go his way, or he wouldn't be able to broker something, kind of an institutionalist middle ground result, which is what he has been aiming for. He did it by first working quietly, working in confidence with one or two other justices. And that has built up resentment over time among the justices on the far right, who have seen him kind of thwart the outcomes he wants. But what's different this time, John, is that Clarence Thomas went public. Clarence Thomas he may have had those kinds of feelings toward the chief, but he has always kept them outside of the, you know, his speeches. He has not been so overt in terms of his complaints. But that is the dynamic behind the scenes. So I think that it just goes to show just how much the tensions are ratcheted up. Part of it, of course, is the disclosure that they're all pointing fingers at each other of who might have caused this. But the bottom line, the most important thing right now, is how far they're going to go on Roe v. Wade. And as I say, it will likely be eventually overruled. It's just a matter of whether it's this year or maybe in the next couple of years, John.
Yeah, it's a good point. Ultimately, it may not be their feelings that matter as much as the actual policy and the decisions that they make. Joan Biskupic, terrific
right.
reporting. Thank you so
Thank
much.
You. Mm-hmm.